In this video, I'm going to share some of the free resources that I use to find answers when I run into a question using Julia. This is not meant to be an exhaustive list, just a small sample of some of the resources available to you. If you have a question about Julia, the first place to check is the official Julia documentation. This is a great resource, but it's a technical document, so it's not meant to be read from beginning to end. But it has an excellent search feature, which I use frequently. The documentation often contains helpful code snippets that you can use to try out on your own. You can also find documentation when using the Julia REPL. The REPL comes included with Help Mode, which you can enter by using the question mark character. The prompt will change, indicating that you are in Help Mode. Help Mode will return any documentation that it can find on your query. There are also help tools available in VS Code. For this example, I'm using the code from the chapter on external packages. In VS Code, the Julia extension will provide you with the documentation if you hover over the code. You can scroll through the documentation by hovering over it and using the scroll wheel on your mouse. We haven't discussed this Julia panel yet, but if you click on the Julia logo icon along the left-hand side of VS Code, you'll see several different Julia panels. One of those panels is a documentation panel, which you can use to search for more information. You can increase the size of this window by hiding the other panels and by moving this vertical bar. Another interesting tool is the Workspace panel. The Workspace panel shows all of the modules, functions, and variables that are active in the current session. In this project, there are two variables named X's and Y's, which contain 1,000 floating point numbers each. 1,000 numbers is too much to display in the REPL, but sometimes you need to see all of the elements. One way that you can do this is by clicking on the View Table icon that will appear if you hover to the right of the variable name. A Julia Table tab will appear showing all 1,000 elements in that vector. You can sort this table by clicking on the column header. Clicking once will sort from low to high. Clicking again will sort from high to low. And clicking a third time will return the vector back to its original order. These are all non-destructive sorts, so you don't need to worry about messing up your data. So those are some of the helpful tools available to you in VS Code. Pluto also contains a helpful tool. For this session, I'm using the notebook from the chapter on Pluto. In Pluto, there's something called Live Docs. Clicking on this button in the lower right corner of the notebook will launch the Live Docs window. As you type in a cell, the Live Docs window will update in real time. If you can't find the documentation that you need, the best place to ask questions is on the Julia Discourse Forum. This resource will let you tap into the collective knowledge of the Julia community. You can also use my GitHub repository to find all of the code that I used in these videos. Finally, one of my favorite websites to learn how to write code in any language is the Rosetta Code website. This website contains a collection of many common programming tasks, along with a code for it written in many different languages. For example, a classic teaching example is something called FizzBuzz. Read the description, and then try to write the Julia code for it on your own. Believe it or not, you know everything that you need to know in order to solve this problem. But as a beginner, there's a good chance that you'll immediately forget everything that you've learned when you try to apply your knowledge. If that happens to you, don't despair. That's totally normal. Developing the ability to apply your knowledge to solve problems will come with experience, and using this website is a great way to get that experience. If you do run into a mental block when trying to solve this problem, that's the perfect learning opportunity. You can find the solution by clicking on this menu button in the upper left corner, and scrolling down until you find Julia and clicking on the link. Here, you'll find several different solutions to this problem. Try typing in one of these solutions using the programming environment of your choice to see if you can get it to work on your computer. Don't copy and paste the code. In order to get experience, you need to practice by typing in the code manually. There are over 1,000 tasks available at the Rosetta Code website. So practice, practice, practice. So those are some of the free resources available to you as you make your way on your Julia journey. The next chapter is the final chapter. Where we'll take a look back to see how far you've come.